In this video, we'll focus on the objective of sales revenue maximization. In firms where ownership and control are separated, managers are hired to run a company on the owner's behalf. Managers could gain more prestige from running a larger firm. It may garner them more respect in the industry to run a $100 million company versus a $60 million company, for example. Higher sales figures are also a performance indicator to lenders, investors, consumers, and other stakeholders. A rise in revenues can be a positive indicator of performance. Firms can also charge lower prices for products as opposed to the prices they could charge if they were to profit maximize. This could allow them to deter new entrants or push existing firms out of the market. A firm may also adopt a strategy in the short run in order to profit maximize in the long run. Let's take a look at the diagram. In an imperfectly competitive market, firms face a downward sloping demand curve. We'll add in our marginal revenue, marginal cost, and average cost curves. Where profit maximization is found where marginal revenue equals marginal cost, sales revenue maximization occurs where total revenue is at its peak or where marginal revenue is equal to zero. This links back to our discussion on marginal values. The sale of the next unit still results in an increase in total revenue. Beyond this point, marginal revenue is negative and thus would reduce the value of total revenue. Coming back to the point at which marginal revenue equals zero, note that the firm is still making supernormal profit, but not the maximum profit possible. The price and quantity are C star and Q star correspondingly. The total revenue of the firm is C star Q star, and total costs are below that. The difference is the area of supernormal profit, as total revenue is greater than total costs. While the firm is still earning supernormal profit, it is not earning the maximum profit possible. Again, it is important to draw your attention to the lower price and higher quantity of output as compared to a strategy of profit maximization. That sums up this brief overview of sales revenue maximization. If you can understand the diagram and the reason why a firm would pursue this objective, you're in good shape. If you have any questions, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com.